Hello friends, welcome to my channel. I am Dr. Himanshu Gupta and I am doing radio diagnosis from Maulana Azad Medical College. I have been guiding students for the past 1 year to get good rank in AIMS, NEET and PGI through my YouTube channel as well as my Facebook page. My Facebook page is Purpose by Himanshu Gupta. I have made a lot of revision videos and strategy videos which has helped a lot of students. So I advise you that you also subscribe to my channel and watch these videos, which will be very helpful in the last 2 months of your preparation. Okay. Now in this video, I will be discussing about bias and I will be giving you examples. So what is bias? Bias is any systematic error in an epidemiological study which produces results that are consistently distorted in one direction or due to non-random factors. Okay, I will repeat the definition again. Is any systematic error in an epidemiological study which produces results that are consistently distorted because of non-random factors. Okay. Now it can be of three types: subject bias, investigator bias or analyzer bias. Now coming to subject bias, it can be of two types. It can be of recall bias or it can be of Hawthorne bias. Okay. Now what is recall bias? Recall bias is the one that happens to many toppers that are giving interviews. So when Sumer Sethi sir asked them, how many hours do you study? What content do you study? They say that we have just studied 6 to 8 hours. And what content? They say that we have just studied DAMS notes. They forget that they did a lot of MCQs during their preparation. They forgot the textbooks that they read during their MBBS time. Okay. So this is a recall bias. What is Hawthorne bias? Hawthorne bias, it is alteration in behavior during study. Okay, now let us examine few students, okay, who are studying 8 hours daily, and then we will see their ranks. What happens is that we see that with time those students are not able to study for 8 hours. For example, there may be a friend of yours whom you think that he has worked hard a lot. You think that he had studied daily for 7 to 8 hours, but still he gets a bad rank in the NEET PG. But what happens is that he was not able to study 8 hours consistently throughout the year. Okay. You only saw him only for few days and you are judging him based on those days only. But throughout the year, he was not performing consistently. So there was alteration in behavior during that study and which produces results that are inconsistent. Okay. Now coming to investigator bias. What is investigator bias? Investigator bias can be of two types. It can be of interviewer bias or it can be of selection bias. So what is interviewer bias? Occurs when cases are given more time than control. Okay, suppose a person is giving to the interview tomorrow. So what happens is that the interviewer will ask only about the marrow question bank, only about the marrow grand test, but he will not ask what other things that he did besides marrow, besides the content of that particular app or the content of that particular institute. So there will be an interviewer bias. What is selection bias? So it is the same as the investigator bias. In this, suppose interviews are being taken, they are only taken of those students who have joined that particular app or that particular institute. Okay, so there will be a bias. There will be an interviewer bias. They will be asked only questions specific for that institute. Okay. Now coming to analyzer bias. what is analyzer bias? Suppose I have to analyze which institutes are the best to get a top rank in AIIMS. I have to analyze between DAMS, Marrow and Prep Ladder. So what I see that they get equal results in AIIMS and PGI. But what happens is that I have been a DAMS student during my test and discussion in internship. So what happens is that I will have a bias towards DAMS. I will say that DAMS is a better institute than other institutes. So this will be an analyzer bias. Now coming to Burkesonian bias. What is Burkesonian bias? Burkesonian bias is due to hospital cases and controls being systematically different from each other. Okay, when there is difference in the admission of patients to the hospitals. Suppose friends, there was no oncology department in your college and we have a study on lung cancer. So there are very few patients coming for the treatment of lung cancer in your hospital. But once there is an oncology department in your college, then the number of cases that will be coming for lung cancer will increase. So this is a Burkesonian bias. Also, I will give you another example. Friends, for the last 5 years, the toppers were only used to be from DAMS because DAMS was the only institute that was providing coaching for medical PG entrance. But from last 2 years, what happens? The number of students joining Marrow also increased. So toppers started coming from Marrow as well. And next year, what you will see that many students have joined Prep Ladder also. So the number of toppers coming from Marrow, Prep Ladder and DAMS will increase. So this is a bias, okay? Because there is difference in the admission of students joining few institutes, okay? Apprehension bias. It is a white coat bias. White coat bias. What happens is that when I ask students questions in front of me, they get scared, they get worried, and they are not able to recall the answer. So that is called apprehension bias. What is Pygmalion bias? Pygmalion bias is that increase in motivation by Sumer Sethi sir increases your rank. Increase in motivation by Sumer Sethi sir increases your rank. That is a Pygmalion bias. What is Golem bias? Decrease in motivation by teachers decreases your rank. A decrease in the motivation by your friend demoralizes you. Okay. Niemann bias. Niemann bias is bias due to missing of fatal cases, mild silent cases and cases of short duration of episodes from the study. Okay. So thank you friends for watching this video. Do subscribe to my channel and do like my video. All the best.